Work, work.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Captain's Draft 3.0 group stages presented by Dota Cinema and Moonduck TV. We are here with our last match of the group stage, Digital Chaos, going up against Team Empire. Empire need to win this series to guarantee themselves an upper bracket spot. Digital Chaos, well, this won't do much for them. They are currently fourth, and they will stay fourth, I believe, even with the win here up against Team Empire. We are here on Moonduck TV. My name is Mott. Joining me today, as always, is Pitmuckle doing observing and producing, and today we have the Dr. Peppered Wizard Savage himself, Grand Grant. What's up, man? How do you feel about the series as we move into it?
Hey, dude, I'm excited for this Resolution versus Empire. Gets his chance to show his old teammates what's up. We get to see a couple stand-ins from Empire, FN from Team Power Rangers, and Bone 7 for DC. So both teams trying out new players currently, they've both said.
Yeah, and Gortz is welcoming out for former HR member from Hellraisers. Gortz is going to be apparently the captain, which is pretty interesting. So he's going to be the one that's drafting here. You mentioned it, Resolution going up against his former team. So there is some, I'm sure, bad blood coming out from both of these squads. And we'll wait and see how this goes. DC have not played particularly well here in Captain's Draft, losing every single one of their series. They did beat Archon last night in the BTS Americas in the Grand Finals. They 3-1 them, and they looked pretty good. But, of course, that was with Mason and not Bone 7. We'll see how Bone 7 does here, as he's going to be the one standing in. They're still trying to find out, I think, their carry player. And I don't know, man. We're going to get it underway. The draft's going to come through, and some interesting bands coming out as well.
Yeah, I mean, Syllabaer, just that hero, I'm surprised it hasn't been banned more. We've seen it first picked. I guess teams aren't scared of it, but it seems to be doing well, except for last game where Alliance just ran over VP Syllabaer.
Yeah, that was a lot of early game pressure, and the lone druid didn't even have time to farm up. He's like, I got my Midas, everybody. Okay, I guess we just lost, huh? That's it. Well, that sucks. There is a Batrider, which I think a lot of teams are starting to use very effectively. I would be a bit concerned about that, but I'm sure there are other heroes that people want to ban out. Let's see, what else is really first ban worthy at this point?
This is actually an interesting pool. There is a lot of carry heroes, a lot.
Yeah, there's not many good supports. There's like Disruptor, I guess Coddle.
Rosta, half of a Nyx, half of a Pudge.
Why do you say half?
I mean, because they're better in other roles. Like, Nyx is better off lane. Pudge is himself. I don't know. Just, you know. And then Zeus. Zeus can be a decent support. We've seen mid more, but yeah, there's the better.
I knew it. I mean, it's going to happen. I mean, that's just one of those great heroes. But DC are going to go for the Nightstalker Zeus. And that's a great. First of all, 1437 plays the Nightstalker so damn well. And Bulba can play it as well in the off lane. I think this is a great pick. I'm not sure about the Zeus, though.
I think Zeus versus Batrider middle. I mean, both are going to start with sticks instead of the normal starting items. And, I mean, both farm decently. Zeus, of course, has to use his Arc Lightning, but Batrider can get stacks up. And depending on the supports from Empire, they can just roam on him early. But with the Disruptor, level 1, 2, 3 roaming isn't that good versus Zeus. But, yeah, I've went Deben, I mean, 1437 plays Nightstar. It has to be his most played hero in, like, the last 50 games, right? Like,
yeah.
It's insane how much
he plays.
He's
played a lot. Yeah, he's played a lot.
And there's CK. We've been seeing him a lot more. He's been coming back into the scene. Mostly in CD. We've seen him a little bit in Captain's Mode as well, but he's just a strong early, mid, and late game. He's like a poor man's Gyro.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. He does have some issues farming up, and he also has issues with maybe his mana. But they actually rectify the issue indirectly by having Mangos available to the Chaos Knight early on in the game. I like the Arteezy build, the one where he goes for Treads, Armlet, I think Drum into a Heart of Trask. I'm a big fan of that. We saw it played last series by Silent, and he went for something a little bit different. I think he went Treads, Manta into Sanj.
He went Treads, Drum, Sanj, and Yasha, then split the Sanj and Yasha into mana. And then he went Hari out.
I like that. That's actually pretty cool.
It's a good hero. Oh, man. There's the Pugnus. So they are getting a super squishy lineup from Digital Chaos, but very push heavy.
Reminds me of the game number one between them and Archon last night. They have a lot of squishy heroes. They do have the Nightstalker picked up, so they have that tanky frontliner that can go ahead and zone out a couple of enemy heroes. The Nyx Assassin will come out. More than likely as either an offlaner or a secondary support, and then the Wraith King comes through for Empire as well. So CK, safe lane, Batrider, perhaps mid. They could do like an aggro dueling with the Wraith King if they want to, like Nyx Wraith King or Disruptor Wraith King. What do you think about that?
Yeah, they have a few stuns. Their early game roaming potential is kind of low, so they'll probably just try to secure like dual lanes with Batrider mid and then do. So I really don't know. It's gonna be interesting how they lane. I'm and
I
then
like this
Digital
draft a lot.
Chaos super confused how they're gonna lane now with Zeus, Pugna, and Keeper of the Light and Night Stalker.
I think Zeus mid Pugna could be a safe lane farmer.
That's
Nightstalker could be
for me to
off
be a game.
lane. And then they just need another support. I don't know, dude. This is a very
Yeah.
strange draft from both teams, really. Like, this is. I'm excited for this. It's gonna be a Lycan, so it is gonna be a Lycan safe lane, and then it's gonna be Nightstalker, perhaps. I don't. It's
Oh, there we
Nightstalker
go,
or off
Bulba.
lane. Yeah, off lane Nightstalker for Bulba. Zeus mid or Pugna mid. It could be a Zeus support for 1437, which I. The last time they played that, which was, I think, yesterday, actually, they got destroyed with it. So I don't know if that's gonna be the greatest idea.
And then see Havost on the next assassin, actually.
Wow. All right. That's not what I was expecting, but we'll see how it works out. I mean, I guess Havost is playing the offlane now, so that's something
Yep.
that you should have to keep in mind
He's a
when.
three roll, so that's gonna be the offlane. They might just do a straight tri-lane with Wraith King Disruptor and Chaos Knight.
I'm down with that.
So then
10 seconds. Although I guess
didn't
playing the carry role too, by the
yeah,
way,
didn't
so.
Resolution play the Lycan when they had that really good
5 seconds
game in
I
DC?
can't remember,
With the yeah, the
honestly.
no boots for like 50 minutes or something crazy. I think that was him, so see if he can pull that off again.
I'll believe you. As we jump into the game, it is DC versus Empire, game number one. For Empire, they could certainly
Prepare
use
for
a
battle.
win here. A series win as well would put them in a great spot, but they're going up against their former teammate Resolution, one of the best mids in Europe. There's a lot of good ones, but he's up there, I think. And he's going to be playing the Zeus this time, which I am a big fan of. That means that this Pugna is a support Pugna played by 1437. So we will have Decrep, obviously Nether Ward and Nether Blast, all good abilities, but he does require a little bit of levels. I'm not sure. How do you feel about the support Pugna, man?
I've never liked it. It's gonna be interesting. I mean, obviously it goes well with the Zeus, but as a Pugna, you're not gonna be. He's mostly gonna be stacking and pulling and doing all that. Both teams actually have reasonably defensive supports with the Pugna, the Caudle, the Disruptor.
Yeah, that's pretty true.
We've been seeing a lot of run at you games like the last two, but this one seems like it might turn into a little
30
more slower
seconds to
paced
battle.
games with both teams. Content with farming until DC wants to start pushing, because I mean they're gonna need to push early.
Yeah, they do. And if they can't get the towers down at a reasonable time, they're going to have to deal with a late game Chaos Knight, which is never fun. Late game Chaos Knight is, well, he's very strong, especially if you don't have ways to deal with him. Obviously, Keeper of the Light is pretty good. The Pugna is pretty good against dealing with him, taking him down through AoE. Maybe getting a Shiva's
The
Guard later
battle
for one of these heroes
begins.
is very important, but.
Yep, and Aoi actually on his Keeper of the Light, if you remember, it was I believe D2L, one of his first tournament with EG when he played the jungle Keeper of the Light, where if you hatchet the tree and he did like six stacks at once or something insane.
12
I don't,
minute Aghanim Scepter for
yep,
AOI 2000.
I remember him and Demon still a Theorycrafter, those two just put that together and it won him the game. It was insane.
Yeah, it was pretty nuts. And well, I don't know if we're gonna see that again. There's no wards coming out in his own jungle. He should be safe, but it looks like he's actually gonna head towards bottom to help out Bulba in this offlane. The aggro dual lane coming out. The Night Stalker is very, very powerful. I think if you can keep him alive, if you can find a couple of last hits, he's gonna get Thunderstrike.
Denied.
And Fennec will go ahead and actually get voided up. They're gonna right click him down. Fennec might get caught here a little bit. 2.5 seconds slow coming out from the void is now gone, and already some pretty good aggression. And Fennec's. He's got six tangos, luckily, because otherwise he'd be in some trouble.
They'd be wasting a lot of time. They know blue is down here somewhere, most likely playing, because they have that ward there. Theban placed or Fort sorry, 1437 placed early. And it is a straight up tri lane, so it's gonna be hard to get kills with this Night Stalker and Keeper of the Light.
Yeah, we'll see how they fare up. Meanwhile, mid lane, FN is gonna go ahead. Already get 5 last hits. Resolution will reset his stacks. This is not a great lane for a Zeus to last hit, and he's slow. He can get run over by Firefly and Sticky Napalm. And Batrider is so dangerous. It's so annoying to play up against for any mid hero. Havost top lane getting destroyed by these Nether Blasts. He doesn't have a salve. He's only got 2 tangos, and he's got 30 HP. I mean, this is going to be an Ixe assassin. He is one of the highest base regens in the game. But still, that is a lot of damage coming out from 4337.
It is good harass. We'll keep him down. He's only 1-0, barely level 2. Yeah, this middle matchup, this is pretty much how it goes. Both of them just, whenever their stick charges get to 10, they just use it and pretty much reset
Ooh.
everything. Yeah, he
A
takes a lot
10.
of damage.
He did take a lot of damage. Arc Lightning and Lightning Bolt. Resolution doing a great job. He's only two last hits behind. If he could stay even with the Batrider, I think he's doing really well for himself.
Yeah, I mean, he has his boots. He needs that chicken, but he's bottle crowing before. So those boots will actually be really slow. We might see FN go on Resolution mid now with his boots up.
Yeah, he just got a Regen rune as well, and FN is going to try to be a bit aggressive. DNA Pump stack still going into Resolution. He's got two up. We'll have to keep our eyes on the other lane. So Post still getting zoned out. He's doing a great job mana burning. 1437 is actually out of mana completely, but he saw, because that mana burn came through in the jungle, he saw that there was a ward there. He'll be able to deward it.
Effectively. Middle
mid lane. Resolution's going to get caught. He's got sticks. I think the Fairy Fire will go. Needs another Arc Light. He gets the first blood. It'll be the Batrider that does that. I thought it was Resolution. It's a kill for a kill, but FN will get on the board first and get the better end of that trade. Bottom, now they're going to get caught out. There's the static, rather the kinetic field coming out. AUI will fall first. Bulba's gonna get chased down. They've got the usage of the stun. 1 second duration. Bulba's in some trouble here. Last Wraith Fire Blast gonna go to work, and they should get this kill. It's a double kill for Phonic here in this bottom lane.
And this is looking good for Empire already. The only lane DC is winning is currently top, but I mean, having your Lycan farm is always amazing. And yeah, we called it. FN just ran out of mid. Zeus didn't have boots, he did, and he had a regen rune. Of course, he didn't get to use it because he died after, but getting that first blood's so big.
Bone 7 harassing out Havos, who's level 3. You look at the Night Stalker, he's level 2 still, so Bulba is going to have some trouble, and he might just need to leech solo experience and try to stay alive as best as he possibly could.
And instead of no boots Lycan, we get tranquil boots Lycan. I
wow.
haven't seen this, but. Oh, middle lane again, Resolution.
They're going to be a dive here, but the rest of the crew is coming in. Gorz is going to look for a Wraith Fire Blast. AUI 2000 is nearby. FN, it's pretty damn speedy. Bulba's looking for a void. He goes down to the low ground. AUI, he's got Illuminate. He's going to right-click FN once or twice. Illuminate Blast is going to come through, and it's just going to barely miss. He gets to the side. He dodges it, sidesteps it, whatever you want to call it. He does stay alive. Good try from FN. Good rotations from the rest of DC. This will provide Resolution the top rune spot, which is going to be an Invis rune. It's pretty damn nice. We'll see what he can do with this.
Yeah, Batrider gets a bounty rune, so Batrider actually farming well, getting the first blood. He gets the experience from the kill as well, and he will. They do not have a flying chicken. He had 4 minutes on Empire. He'll walk out his tranquils.
Bulba is not getting any experience right now. Level 2, him and AUI are both struggling to find experience. 1437, gonna see Havos. There's gonna be the usage of the Nether Blast, and it is level 2 now, so. But they're gonna try to gank. It's nighttime. He's got no usage of the Spike Carapace. He's got an Impale, but this is gonna be a kill for Bone 7, and Bulba will be able to get some of that experience and some of that gold going his way. So that's at least something going for Bulba in the top lane.
He gives him enough money to pick up the Quelling Blade, so now he can at least jungle a little bit better before he gets that Iron Talon.
That's something for him.
And this CK is just straight free farming.
He's having a great time. Treadzorp now. South Shield, we'll see what he goes for next. I'm really interested in seeing the build that the CK is going to pick up, but the Zeus has gone for a Soul Ring. Interestingly enough, whether that is going to be a Bloodstone or just a casual Soul Ring remains to be seen. Pretty nice grab.
Yeah. It's funny to think Funnik playing a support for Empire, Havost playing offlane for Empire.
Yeah.
Back when Funnik played the offlane and Havost played the carry, they're showing their little bit of move around.
Havost might get ganked again. Staff Spike Carapace still. The Decrep's going to come out and they can't quite get in range of the Void. Now they can. There's going to be the Howl as well with the Impale. He'll hit it on his team, might actually live because of it. That's a huge Impale.
Wow.
They needed to dodge that. Resolution's gonna get caught. Gortz is gonna come behind the tower. The Wraith Fire Blast will go. A couple of stacks. He's got two. There's gonna be the Zeus ult. They will get the kill to Gortz. Resolution will fall to the fire. He sticks up. He won't fall. The lightning bolt gets a double kill. Resolution says, "How do you do, former team? Yeah, I see you. I know you want to kill me. No, it's not gonna happen this time around, baby. I got you."
Meanwhile, the Pugna dies top in a 3v1 gank. Havost comes away with something.
That's huge for Havost. I feel like that gets him to level 4. He's now got a Spike Carapace. Definitely not as easy to gank anymore because of that, but the stun rate is only 0.6, so.
And now Resolution 7 at 6 minutes in after he was, like, losing the lane. Now he has so much damage output.
Yeah. That's huge for him. And he just bought something, too. He has a full Arcane, so it looks like he might actually go for an early Bloodstone here, Grant. What do you think?
That's good. I think Sumail started doing that, and more people are going that instead of, like, the normal lens. I think Bloodstone's always good. That's probably an Aether lens.
Oh, Aether lens is the main thing,
yeah. New items, dude. There's just too many of them.
Yeah,
like the Scarlet Robes and scarfs and stuff. I don't even know anymore.
Scarlet Robe would be a cool item name, unless that was in Han.
No, I don't think so.
Okay, well.
They're trying to kill this ward. They're using a lot of bolts to get it.
Yeah, they used to. Their resolution will get it done nonetheless. The Arcane Boots are about to fly out. Meanwhile, top lane, Bone Saven has picked up Free Farm. He's actually picked up the Sage's Mask. I don't think there's anything else in the Courier. Oh, it's Vlad's. He's getting close to it, too. He's actually a Morbid Mask away from having the Vlad's, I believe. The recipe as well. But that's it. Firefly. Lightning Bolt will go Arc Lightning. Resolution's got a Zeus ult. It's a lot of damage, the level 4 bolt. Until they scale up later on down the road, Resolution will continue to be annoying. And FN is top of the net worth right now, but just by a little bit. If you look at the net worth graph, it is actually a 250 advantage by Empire. That is pretty much nothing. But we'll see. The biggest thing is DC need to have this early game aggression. We'll see.
Yeah, they're fine with just farming because Bulba had nothing. They want to farm to like 10, 11, and then they can start pushing towers with the level 4 Wolves, Nether Blast. But it is a support Pugna, so it's coming slowly. And he's actually leveling his Nether Ward over his Blast right now.
Yeah, that's fine. I think that's good. The Ward does more damage as it scales up later. And I think, what else scales? Mana regen reduction.
Look at that quick Vlad's 8 minutes.
Yeah, that was nicely done. And he also had his Tranquils first as well, so... Bulba is level 3. He is having a rough game. I think he's lowest in experience right now, tied with the Wraith King. But the Wraith King is not an offlaner, so...
And I think the no stuns from DC versus, what, like, the almost 4 stuns from Empire? I think it's going to show in the team fights, we'll see.
There's a lot of disables here, right?
And if we see Havos, I can't believe he still hit that double stun top, and it was just a little thing, but it saved his life.
It really did. He would have gone down again. He would probably be right around where Bulba is with the experience had he not at least gotten that stun off and then transitioned it to a kill. Zeus, we'll see if he can get involved pretty soon. FN just trying to get to his blink dagger. He's got 1300 gold. They might gank him. You can see roaming in is going to be Bone 7. Is he just going to smoke it head bottom? He's not looking for Roche yet. He's going to try to find a kill on Aloha Dance. This could be huge. They're going to spot him out, though, walking through the jungle. The Shapeshift will fly. The Wraithfire Blast is going to go. There's going to be the Kinetic Field as well. The Howl will fly. Zeus ult will go as well. Phonix getting low. And can he chase him down? TP should come through. They have Wraithfire Blast, but not the mana for it. And Phonix just going to die. Bone 7 gets a free trip back. But now he's going to get caught. Wraithfire, rather, the usage of the Cast Bolt. They get off the usage of that lasso as well. Bone 7 in trouble. Can he get out? He's low. Another Reality Rift in, and they'll pick up the kill. And that was just a great rotation and a good timing from Empire. They would have gotten that kill on Aloha Dance had they not walked through the jungle at the exact time and spotted out Bone 7.
That hurts, losing your Lycan. Only to kill a Disruptor, yep.
That is really bad for them.
Because they wanted to do one of those, let's gank the lane and then push the tower.
Or
instead they just
burn
the tower, yeah. And they can do a Roche. We might try to see a smoke Roshan come up, but you have to assume Empire's ready for it.
Yeah. They should be good to go. There is going to be an Arcade Rune I think they want to give to Zeus. It has not been scouted out by Gortz. Maybe it is now. Yeah, he sees it, but still. I don't think they're going to go for it. Maybe they will. They're going to drop up a ward. I think they might have seen that. There's going to be a Raid Fire Blast on the 1437, and Gortz will grab up the Arcane Rune himself. Decrypt will fly. There's going to be another blast as well, but here we go. They're going to look for 1437. They're looking for Reality Rift in. Aloha Dance came through, and he's got his drum as well as his treads up and ready to go. That is a decent amount of damage, and he's going to go in right on a creep. Bulba is able to reach some experience bottom, but he's not even at level 6 yet, whereas the,
Vost, yeah.
Vost is level 7, actually.
Yeah, he just got left alone top for like 3 minutes while they did all that ganking. Now he's going to gank bottom.
Yeah, he's going to gank bottom. He's going to have his Vendetta. They're going to turn around with the Phantasm here, but he might have done it too early. So 4-37 as well as Bulba will back up together and just say, I do not want to deal with that.
This is Empire Demon just getting treads, their beginning items. They're just going to start running at DC.
Ooh, that is a blink now done for the Batrider.
And a smoke. So he will be going for that first early, obviously. Not scouted out gank. Hope to get a high priority target.
Yeah, we'll see where he heads. He might look for top lane. All right, he's going to need some help if he wants to go for the Lycan, though. Bone 7's going to be picking up. It looks to be... the Necro book, unsurprisingly. And here we go. There's the Firefly. Blank's gonna go. The last is gonna fly as well. And Bone 7 is gonna get pulled back behind the tower. The Impale will fly through the Wraith Fire Blast as well. He's in trouble. He's not going to be able to shapeshift down. He'll be able to make some wolves before he goes down. But there it is, the blink smoke gank coming out from FN the Batrider, and they get the job done.
And you saw Aoi's ult was up. I mean, Blinding Light wouldn't have done anything there. They just have too much magic damage, too much stuff. They have just so much damage on Empire.
Yeah, they have a lot. They have a lot of disables, as you mentioned, as well. So there's going to be some BKBs needing to come out for a couple of these heroes, specifically the Lycan. But what does Resolution have? He's been free farming as well. He's up to 1600. Yeah, he has enough for an Aetherlens, so he's not going for it just yet, anyways. I'm going to head bottom. DK, 5,000. He is going Armlet. So Treads Drum Armlet. This is similar to what Arteezy does with his build. We'll see if he goes for a hard afterwards. I think that's a fine build. He picks it up.
I think that or Sanj and Yasha are both extremely good. Gives you insane amount of damage and, yeah, little HP.
Yeah, we'll see. It's a good chance it's probably one of those two.
They have a smoke on chicken. There we go. Aloha Dance and Gourds.
Yeah, they're going to add bottom, I think. There's three down here, though. And Lycan could get in pretty soon as well.
I'm surprised they're not scouting out the Roche right now. I mean, he's not doing it, but it's only a pretty good. Oh, and
1437 is going to break the smoke. They know that he's there now. But that's going to be the end of the gank. They can actually still go for this. The Thieven might be in trouble. Reality Rift, he's not quite in range. He just gets it as well. He gets off the Nether Ward. Now there's going to be the Firefly looking for another lasso. The Vendetta, the Impale, hits on a Bulba. He's going to fall. They don't even need the lasso. They use it nonetheless. Reality Rift comes through. These disables are insane. And they find two easy pickoffs down in that bottom lane. DC are in some trouble here, I think.
Yeah, I feel they just, I wouldn't say got outdrafted, but the style they wanted to play is just, it's working against them. There's so many stuns, and they can't push with the Lycan and Pugna because of it.
Yeah.
They run into a tower, and what are they going to do when they get stunned, like, four different times?
The threat of the disables is pretty damn solid, and we'll see how it transitions. Aloha Dance is getting up to that armor. I think he actually has the, no, he needs the Helmet Iron Will. No, he hasn't. He needs the Blade of Attack, rather. Bulba's going to come through looking for a Void. He's not that fast. He doesn't have Phase Boots. If he had Phase, he'd be fine. But again, they had this ward behind the tower. Empire has great vision, but here we go. Bones have been looking for Frontic. The Static Storm used. Glimpse has not been used yet, but the Zeus will fly, and Resolution will get the kill. As he's rotated bottom, now Aloha Dance getting caught, but Bulba getting stunned for 3 seconds. The Blinding Light comes out. Can they get this kill? He's pretty damn fast. He's popped the Drum Charge. Bulba's still on the chase. He's looking for the Void. He almost got it off. Instead, he's going to have to back away. These illusions doing too much damage to him. The Nether Ward comes through as well. It's going to get dropped in. Well, they'll lose one in the middle lane. And Batrider picks up the Lycan top again. The Firefly Lasso, not even needed. He just actually chased him down with Sticky Napalm and Firefly. I think maybe just the Sticky Napalm, actually. He got the kill. Obost has been spotted out. They've got the Sentry. The Silence will go. Vendetta comes out. Bulba in trouble. Lightning Bolt will fly. And Resolution is keeping them in this game now with a Blink Dagger up and ready to go.
Yep,
they'll take that kill.
I know it's the little thing, it's just smart. He silences so he can't Carapace at all before he does anything else and makes it an easy kill. Resolution played middle so well now. It's paying off.
I'm going back to the draft though, and I think DC probably should have just banned out the Batrider. I do not think the Morphling ban was needed.
Especially
like
without Yawar. And Yawar is the only one who really likes playing that. I mean, I'm sure Bone 7 can, but.
Yes. Well, he's been known to play Batrider, but it's often been in the off lane, which is not really a thing that you do anymore. I mean, I've seen it a couple of times, but.
And now he's Zeus gonna go for the Aetherlens, paying him the Ring of Health.
Yep, and that will be the Aetherlens coming out, as you mentioned. They have the usage of the armlet up on the Aloha Dance. They're gonna drop a kinetic field, the lasso. See you later, Thieven. You are gonna get destroyed. Zeus will fly, 4 second stun. Here comes the Lycan looking for Gortz. He's got the usage of the reincarnation, though, so I don't really think it's a big issue. Bulb is getting slowed up. They're gonna glimpse back Resolution. The tier 1 tower in trouble. It's in denying range, and everyone else will back up Empire, realizing they kinda got away with murder there. And they will back up together.
Yeah, Blinding Light plus Pugna Wards stopping these pushes pretty well.
Boast vendetted up looking for a target. Bone 7 might be the one. He can't bring him down solo. Try to find a lower HP target. AUY 2000 might be a good kill to go for. Drum Charge pop. They're looking for Reality Rift. He's got a Blinding Light and try to stay alive. A Boast nearby gets off the double impale. The Wraith Fire Blast goes in as well. And that's going to be two dead heroes, including Resolution, which had a mega kill spree. And so Havos comes in, gets the job done with the Vendetta yet again. And Empire looking for more. They're looking for the usage of getting that Kerr effing can't quite find it. Here's the shapeshift. Can they get this kill? The stun on Debo 7. They have so many disables. They get off the impale as well. And the last couple of right clicks will go, but they actually get off the decrep. Nicely done. There's the silence up as well. And still though, DC can't find these kills. Everyone's gonna live. They're not getting punished for diving on Empire's side. And DC continues to just try to find a way to get back into this game, but it's not working.
And they just don't have the heroes too, and like, yeah, just all those stuns. They can just go heal, go back and fight. And Havosh just got so much farm from getting both those kills.
There's an Anthem Lens at least for AUI and the one for the Zeus as well, but they need detection, they need BKBs, it's so tough to survive in this game right now if you're DC, I think.
And you look at the heroes and you're like, wait, I thought DC should be the team pushing, not Empire.
Right, exactly. Empire has done a great job this game of stopping any sort of pushing themselves into the tier 1 towers, into the tier 2 towers, and finding plenty of kills. So I don't know where you go for DC here, but they've got a long road ahead of them.
You know, just hope they pick off some kills with Resolution, Pugna, and do a lot of damage.
They'll see the Pugna walk down bottom lane as there's a ward there again I talked about earlier. They're going to probably go on him here. Yeah, this is... they're looking for it at the very least. They really want the tier 1 tower as well. DK continues to farm up. They will have a couple of heroes top lane, but AUI2000 is going to TP bottom. Here's the Firefly Lasso, blink forward. They're going to find Bulba as well. Wraith Fire Blast, 4 second stun. He gets decrepit, but the Firefly is doing a lot of damage. He'll get brought down. 4037 will be next. They even drew up the Netherworld, but it still will do nothing as FN gets the double kill. Right now, Empire are styling on DC, and this looks like it is their game to lose, essentially, Grant.
Yep, they do get the top tower, but you just lost two of your heroes, and FN's had like 4 haste runes now. He's been pretty lucky with those haste runes.
I would agree. He's had a good time in general.
And here we go, TP in. Bonestone needs to be careful. Oh, he gets stunned.
Yeah, there's the impale coming up. He has the shapeshift still, but they do enough last rope. 2 second stun from the usage of the Chaos Bolt. He's going to shapeshift to try to get out, but sadly, with the Reality Rift, Aloha Dance will find an easy kill with the armlet. The amount of damage that he does is insane. He's up to 2,377 gold. He can buy a Vitality Booster, he can buy Assange. AUI is going to get glimpsed back. The Firefly, the Sticky Napalm, the Wraith Fire Blast. The Zeus ult will come through, trying to bring down Funnic, but it's just not enough. Even with the decrep on him, 1437 is going to get caught. Wraith Fire Blast will fly. A couple more right clicks. Resolution will come in. Lightning Bolt onto F, and they want that kill. Flame Break will not bring him down. The Urn Charge will, however. And Gortz will get yet another kill. And DC have not gotten a kill since, I think, let's see here. It's been about 14 minutes, 13 minutes. Yeah, it's been a while. Let's just go with that.
Those things, stuns versus no stuns, we can keep saying it. It's just impossible to get kills when you have a Caudle and a Pugna as your support.
Yeah, I mean, this draft has really just not been good for DC. But for Empire, they've played extraordinarily well. I mean, there's really no... I don't know how DC get back into this game, because Empire have just good late game. They've got good cores. They're all getting farmed. There's a blink on the Nyx Assassin. The Batrider has that, and a Force F is getting close to the BKB. And it looks like if you're DC, they're just going to try to go for a desperation rush. But guess what? FN has scouted it out completely. He knows that this is happening. He'll Firefly up. He's got the lasso, but he maybe needs his team here first and foremost. The Wolves will try to scout him out and stop him from blinking it by attacking him, but that might be the other thing they can do.
Purple just farming insane amounts. Almost 4k gold now on the CK. Probably will be going
to buy a heart. Just get a heart.
And we'll say, oh, we do.
Oh,
smoke.
Did they smoke on that ward? They might have.
It's nighttime, so I don't think they did.
Yeah, I think you're right, actually.
But they have to know what's coming. They're either in Roche now. Look at all those sentries from Dire.
Yeah, and also if they didn't see, they would just see them go back here into that ward, which never happened. So they could either assume that A, they're in Roche, like you said, or B, they're looking.
They
for
do spot out Havos with that sentry ward.
Yeah, they'll drop another one down. Havos smartly will not move any further forward.
Look at how many sentries they have around Roche. 5.
Yeah, it's a lot. It is 5, I think. 1.
Yep.
2, 3, 4. At least 4.
The one on Roche, too.
Oh, yeah, they got that. Yeah, you're right. 5. They have actually got 5.
It's a lot of gold.
Yeah. Well, Havos, he actually already used his Vendetta, but it's back up and ready to go now. And everyone's going to get out of Roche. They actually have an illusion coming through. That's the next illusion. Honestly, I feel like Empire can maybe just take this. There's no real threat of DC going to the pit. They don't have Lasso. The only real problem is maybe Zeus Hold
They, yeah,
than it
Zeus
was.
Hold, Pugnawart, and Caudal Blast. It is a lot of damage. It'd be tough to fight.
Aloha Dance is saving up so much money. He could just buy a component of whatever item. He just
oh,
buys a full
BKB.
BKB.
All right.
That's another one of those choices that he could have gone for. And in this game, especially against the Zeus, against the Pugna, and even
yeah,
against
the
Nightstalker.
Guess we should have seen that. Oh, well.
Yeah.
That'll happen.
That's fine, though. That's a great build. He's up to 10,000 net worth now. Meanwhile, Bone7's still only at Necro 1. And he's about to get ganked. FN's coming up here on the top lane. Firefly, the Blink Blast will go. Four staff to pull him back into Havosa. Will get off the Impale, but no Vendetta. Actually misses out on a little bit of damage there, but he should still fall here. Spike Airface will go. Havosa will blink in front of him to try to body block, but not necessary as FN will bring him down with Sticky Napalm and the Firefly going to work.
They're playing methodically at this point. Every time Batrider's ults up, they're somewhere they need to be with one other person and easy kill.
Yeah. Nicely done.
Goldgriff almost 10,000 now. Same experience. Both are exactly the same.
And it's just there's no way DC can really get back into this, even if they take the towers. Their team fight is not nearly good enough, and I don't know if it ever will be.
Especially with the BKB, 10-second BKB Chaos Knight right now, just running at your Pugna, your Zeus, your Keeper.
They could use something. They could use a hero that has something that goes through BKB, like a Batrider, for example, a Lasso, or they could maybe need a Hex or something, but that's very far away. Speaking of BKB, they'll get another one for FN. The Batrider has picked it up, and he's ready to go, and they're going to go ahead and head towards bottom. Resolution and crew have some great vision in the enemy jungle, but that's about it. They really... obviously, we'll back up when they see Gortz nearby, but they still haven't been able to get Roshan. There's a ward still there. They will see Bone7 walking through essentially the secret shop, and it is about to go down at the very least. Gortz is going to find AUI 2000, more than likely. He'll try to TP out. Like he actually might make it away. He will.
Oh, it's like 0.2 seconds left.
Yeah, Gortz is about to fire his Wraithfire Blast. That's some smooth play from AUI, but still, the push will commence for Empire, and it looks like it's going to be time to take down this tier 2 and one of the last out of towers in the game.
And Glimmer cave up on Funic. We haven't really seen much from him. We haven't really needed to. He's just thrown a glimpse here there and got some kills.
Yeah, he's not really been involved. He's 3-2 and 4, so he actually has been in a couple of kills, but I feel like he could have been maybe involved a little bit more. FN blinks forward. Looking for a potential pickoff onto AUI, but instead he'll find a creep wave for himself. The Necro 2 is done for the Lycan. They are trying to push up these waves, but they're just not doing it fast enough as they're already losing their tier 2 tower. And I think FR could probably back this into Roche now with this tier 2 gone. We'll see.
If they want, they can. They might go for base. I doubt it. There's too much with the Pugna and Caudal. They might force out TPs. Looks like they will.
Radiance Havos will go back home, it looks like.
Yep. Now they see the Caudal Blast, they're like, alright, we can't push.
Yeah, they'll just clear out the creep wave, though. I mean, really, Empire don't have to rush this dude. They have so much farm at this point, and they're such a better team in terms of late game. They really don't have to rush this.
Yeah, they just have to make sure they don't get a split pushed by Bone7, and they're doing a good job of that. Look at FN actually sees him, too.
Sees him. Gets off the Necro looking to pop the BKB, but he can't blink forward. He's scared of Bone7, understandably, so he gets mana burned, and all of a sudden all of his mana is gone, and maybe he's getting caught. He'll force away from the Lycan Wolves as well. They had nobody else in that top lane. Gortz wasn't quite there. Though at least BKB is forced for Bone7. Nicely done, I guess.
Hey, you take all the wins you can.
Not really. If we're talking about that, you know this game's going poorly for DC. But again, Empire just playing this super outstandingly well. And Aloha Dance will just walk right up to the high ground to try to find somebody.
Book 3, now up on the Lycan though. So if they do try to fight, I mean, they can take out the Wraith King really easily. Take down all his mana, just kill him. No ult, but you want that book on someone a little more important.
Yeah, it's going to be tough. Meanwhile, down bottom, Havos has been ended up, Shadowing Bone7. Nobody's there, so he can't really solo kill him. Doesn't have a Dagon or anything. And the tier 2 tower mid will fall as this shadowing is occurring. DC's just gonna back into their base. They can't defend outer towers at this point. There's one outer tower left. That's the tier 2 tower top lane. So they get it back up into Roche is the question. And it looks like that might be the case here.
And a Reaver on Chaos Knight.
Yeah. He is very farmed. Once he gets this hard, I'm pretty sure the game just ends, essentially.
Yeah, most likely. 3K, 10 illusions just attack you.
Especially if he gets the bonus illusion coming out. The extra phantasm.
Resolution's still 3K, though. I'm not really sure what he goes here, though.
I don't know if he can buy anything that will, like, win his team a team fight. I don't know.
A refresher, a little more damage, but if he's the one who gets blinked on and Batrider, he's just out.
It's not even that, too. It's just that if they get their BKBs off.
Exactly. I mean, they're all 9, 10 seconds still.
Yeah. Empire will slowly but surely take down this Roshan. That will be probably an Aegis for Chaos. And he's the extra slot. And so not only does he have an Aegis, he's fantastic. He's extraordinarily farmed. He's 13,000 in net worth Empire. It's been a great game for them. They'll pick up the Aegis now. 27 minutes. We've seen not many kills recently. It's actually... The last kill we saw was... back towards 21 minutes, so it's been about 6 minutes or so.
Look at this Bone 7. Oh, Bone 7's gonna go for funny.
I don't know if this is gonna work. Boomer Cape will fly, the kinetic field will go. He actually has Vision coming up with the Necro Warrior. The Impale is gonna be missed. He might still go for this. He thought about it. He's like, I really want to kill. He's gonna send Flips back in onto Bone 7, but there are people coming. He should be able to get away just in time, and yeah, it'll be fine.
Yeah, Funic almost dying, just kiting him around.
Where do we go from here, man? We just have to wait until Empire slowly but surely inevitably pushing the base.
Yep, just Empire just does their thing when they feel safe enough pushing. I mean, because they're gonna have to push versus the blast of Caudle and Pugna. Radiant's
middle tower is under. Yeah, that is gonna be the tough spot. I think they want to probably get a, like many other teams, they want to get a pick before they try to head to high ground.
Yeah, Vlad's almost up on Wraithcamp. Surprised they're not getting a pipe on anyone.
Yeah, I think they will eventually. I don't know on who, but they're going to grab it. It's so good against Zeus, and it gets Caudle.
Resolution picked up a soul booster on the chicken, so...
Octarine or perhaps the Bloodstone?
Octarine or Bloodstone. I assume Octarine, but...
They've picked up the axe for Bulba. I mean, they're getting farm. It's just I don't know if it's going to be enough at this point. Empire are too damn far ahead. Funic's going to start building his axe with the point booster, and he's almost got a second component. But down bottom, he might get caught here. The static storm will fly. Bone 7 in some trouble. He's got a second 3 back up at 12, but he's going to get last, so the life drain will go. And FNL's going to go to work on Bone 7. He's got shapeshift. The BKB will fly, and he's going to get brought down. The Impale will not get the kill. It's going to be FN doing the job. 4-37 will TP away. Let him pick up the Nether Ward as well. And while this is all happening, Aloha Dance is split pushing top, and he's going to get the tier 2 tower as his heart is just about completed. He's about to have a 29-minute heart, armlet, BKB, treads, drum on this Chaos Knight.
Yeah, that is pretty good.
Yeah.
That's one of the highest GPM middle lane.
They're going to go for it. They're looking maybe for Bulba, but they're going to find it. Gortz gets off the Wraith Fire Blast. Here's the Riata ripped in. They're looking for the Chaos Bolt, but he gets silenced up. Aloha Dance. He's got the heart, he's pretty tanky. They'll regen up here, the Zeus will fly. That'll get the reincarnation at the very least for it. And now that is going to be down for 85 seconds, so they might want to try going. Aloha Dance will regen up now with his heart. And look how fast he does regen, it's insane. He's going to be back to full health here momentarily. The Illuminate will fly through, that'll put it on cooldown. And Aloha Dance will continue to go up to the work and on this high ground. FN just actually blinks in, looking for a last, can't find it. There's the tier 3 tower getting destroyed as they pop up the Phantasm. They pop up the Nether Blast as well, but it's not doing anything. This glyph will finally come through. Illuminate comes in, and they're really just Empire brute forcing this. They actually get a beautiful Blinding Light in. This should be the Aegis, and it will be. But now it looks like maybe FN and the rest of Empire will want to try to fight off this. The Kinetic Field will fly, so they can't go any further. There's going to be the usage of the Mana Leak. It's going to get him pretty low, but it'll stay stale for the moment. He's got the little Glimmer Cape as well to cover his retreat. They'll take the tier 3 tower, and it's surprised they don't take any more than that. But it's a pretty good hold, I suppose, for DC stopping the Aegis and getting the reincarnation as well.
Yep, you know, just playing it safe, like we said. No reason to push it. Did they win this? The winner's bracket is always better than the loser's bracket.
Yeah, it's just they need this win, right? Not even the full series, right?
They need the series.
Okay. Well, game number one looks pretty good, yeah. for Empire. Not to say they. God
dude,
it.
Have you had pears in a while? No. Pears are actually one of the best fruits, I think. Sorry, just throwing that out there. Pears are very good.
No, I actually haven't had pears for a long time. I forget what they taste like.
They're crunchy and sweet like an apple, but they got that soft texture like inside of a kiwi.
That sounds pretty good. I'm going to have to buy a pear now.
Yeah, and a kiwi.
I'm going to Phoenix. JJ, get on top of that. Give me a kiwi, bud. You know what to do.
What? Sorry, I didn't listen. What is happening?
You need to get a pear and a kiwi for Mount.
Yeah,
All
I
right,
need
all right.
those.
Yeah, I'm on it.
Thanks,
Thanks, dude.
JJ. Thanks, man. What a great guy he is. Not only is he a producer and observer, he's also somebody that just gives me food all the time. Great person.
They're still just. Oh, wait, here we go. Now they're coming down middle.
Are they gonna
Gortz
push
has his
finally?
Vlads up now. A little more armor, a little more. I mean, the lifesteal with his aura. Insane.
Yeah, they're gonna go straight for this Rax now as it exposed. They don't have a tier 3 tower. Here comes the creep wave. The Arc Lightning will fly. They're gonna jump in looking for Lasso, but a great blink away coming up from Resolution, so he avoids it. As these FN blinks then have been pretty, they've been trying to go for it, but he can't find anything.
And they've been ballsy. And they have to commit Havoc's bottom so they don't get split pushed by Bone 7 somehow.
They want going Lotus Orb? I feel like it's pretty damn good this game.
Not yet, I'm surprised. Surprised Lotus Orb or Pipe on Empire.
Maybe Link is also for AUI. Let's see what else is going on. Havos TP's bottom. There has been a Demon Edge picked up for a Lala Dance for Zenith MKB. I don't. Yeah, I guess he just goes Rapier. I don't think so, but no.
He does the Arc Warden build on Chaos Knight.
Is he really?
I don't.
Oh, FN is in trouble. It looks like. Oh my god, he actually caught out the BKB TP.
Oh.
And the Zeus ult is too early, and Resolution cannot find the kill. That was so much gold just from that one kill, and they can't get it done. Oh, that's devastating.
I don't even think if he didn't have the BKF, he would have got the kill. And now look at, because if they committed so much, they just.
Oh my god, Reanna, if the AY 2000's about to just get destroyed, the 4 second stun. He is done. Aloha Dance is taking a lot of damage here. Another blast will fly. They're gonna glimpse him back. There's gonna be the BKB pop and the other Rax is done. Aloha Dance should leave. He's so low, actually, and they're about to bring him down. The Glimmer Cape will go. That is a full 10 second charge BKB duration. Bulba's gonna get stunned up. He needs gonna fall here momentarily. Maybe kill spree. Bone 7's gonna come through. Aloha Dance has already regened, and there's three dead on DC. And I think they might just GG out at this point without any buybacks
Good call,
on
man.
Bulba as well as. Of course, the Coddle, and that is going to be it for game number one. Great draft from Empire. DC struggling here, not having the best draft for themselves, and really the Batrider, FN, having a great game along with Aloha Dance's Chaos Knight.
Yeah, his GPM was actually insane. Well, I guess we'll find out right here, but
probably 600.
Yeah, just, I would say this was a pretty big draft game. Just stuns versus no stuns, and then you win your lanes because you have the stuns and. The Caudal War, or the Pugna War, the Caudal Blast just doesn't do that much since they're getting so much farm on Empire.
Well, that was an impressive display coming out from Team Empire. Really good stuff coming out from a couple of the standings, FN and Gortz as well. DC, Bone7 played the light game, but unfortunately did not go well for them. And so it looks like DC, they have to maybe get a victory here to get this to game number three, but it might not even matter here at the end of the day. Empire need one more victory to get into the winner's bracket. We'll see if that's going to be the case. We're here on Moonduck TV. My name is Mont. With me is Pimp as well as Grant. We'll see you guys for game number two.